it's the all-conquering Michael van Gerwen.
Michael van Gerwen, the odds-on favourite, is out!
Phil Taylor breezes through.
Can he stay on course for number 17? That's the question on everybody's lips in here. This is what we've seen so far tonight, an absolute classic match. Peter Wright coming through an amazing game with Dave Chisnell, 4-3. Alan Norris will play the winner of our final match of the evening. He beat Mark Webster 4-1. And next, the world champions collide, Phil Taylor against Jelle Klassen. Draw looks like this. Gary Anderson against James Wade. Alan Norris will take on the winner of Phil Taylor against Jelle Klassen. The match we're about to see now. Top half of the draw, Barney against Michael Smith. Adrian Lewis against Peter Snakebite Wright. Wayne Miles alongside with a sort of a calm before the storm. Everybody expectant, but wondering what Taylor is going to turn up tonight.
Well, yeah, I just think that Phil is now one of these players that you're not too sure how he's going to play. He used to be Mr. Reliable, always more or less around the 100 average. I think if he's anywhere near that, I think he'd take care of Jelle. Jelle was far too inconsistent, really was, in his last match against against Mervyn King. First round match was superb, the highest of the first round, but that is Jelle Klassen. Averages 102, then 92. I cannot in any way see Phil Taylor playing as poor as he did against Kevin Painter. I just don't see it. He keeps on about, I was nervous. You've got to get over that at some point. You've got to. It's human nature that you get used to a situation eventually. And maybe this is the match. I'm not sure. I just find Phil really hard to read at the moment.
Let's find out. We'll chat more in a moment. Let's get this match up and running. Taylor is coming next.
Yeah.
The one we've been waiting for at Sky Sports Darcy. What are your predictions now? The crowd of Fever Pitch singing Taylor's name. Will his dreams of a 17th world title come to an end before the quarterfinals? Or can he book a place in the last eight against Alan Norris? Wayne Miles alongside Rod Studd in commentary. Wayne, was there a bit more of a spring in the Taylor step tonight?
I think so, Dave. There's even a little smirk on his face. He definitely looks happier. Maybe it is because of the demise of Michael van Gerwen, beaten by Raymond van Barneveld yesterday. Or maybe he just feels better. Maybe Phil Taylor is going to bring his practice game onto the World Championship stage, which is what he hasn't done yet. But I thought it was really interesting that Jelle Klassen mentioned that Phil Taylor doesn't seem secure in himself. Has that fear factor gone? Phil Taylor is still a threat, is still a potential winner, as is this man, Jelle Klassen, the 2006 BDO World Champion.
97. Klassen invited to go first. The characteristics of Phil Taylor's first two matches against Keita Ono and Kevin Painter were
100.
Erratic starts where he was averaging in the 80s, followed by superb finishes where he was averaging over 100 in the 60. Last couple of sets of both those matches. What will happen tonight? Well, that's an ideal start.
99.
Well, these two have one thing in common. They both won the World Championship on their debut. Phil Taylor in 1990.
134.
Jelle Klassen in 2006. They haven't played in a competitive match since February this year. Just a tour event, best 100. Of 11 legs that Jelle Klassen won 6-2. Before that, their last meeting was 2010. So, really, no relevant
100.
Form to go by.
Must stay there, you would think.
50.
Well, Jelle Klassen, all things being equal, will get first shot at a double in this match. All the money for Jelle Klassen today to win this match. Backed into 5-2 from 7-2 to knock Phil Taylor out as he leaves.
52.
Double 12.
Another 60. Oh, is he staying there? Yes.
140. Only required 24. A shot in the first
leg to Jelle Klassen. We saw Phil Taylor against Kevin Painter find it really hard to settle. Thought his darts were going in pretty well in that first leg. Maybe needs to throw them a tad harder, but
100.
Wasn't spraying them all over the place like he was against Kevin.
Block, block.
99.
Managed to find a way through. Well, Klassen's two games, chalk and cheese. First game, breathtaking. Second game, bewildering. In terms of the quality of his play, he had the highest first round average in his first match, didn't he, against Joe Cullen. Against Mervyn King, much more steadier player, missed a heck of a lot of doubles.
Jelle Klassen was the only man to average in three figures in the first round. Phil looks better tonight. Not because he's hit 260s, they're going in better. Throwing with more authority. Maybe.
140.
MVG getting beaten is just the fillip you needed.
A fillip for Philip. Fourteen.
89.
Leaves double 16. Very authoritative first leg on throw from the power. Could be a 13 dart leg. Mind you, hello.
168.
Hang on a minute.
68. Fill your required 32.
Never been conventional, is he, Yeller?
Aim short in the second.
First start. The double for Phil Taylor. Penetrates the double 16.
44.
I know it's early days, but this is as good as Phil Taylor has looked.
100.
Yeah, started so much better than he did in his opening two ties. Even that's missing in an area where he wouldn't be too disappointed, just below the treble bed, and then following it in, something he wasn't doing in the first couple of matches also.
Yeah, the first match having terrible trouble grouping. Using different darts in the first match to what he's been using the last year or so. Change back to the Generation 2. With just an intermediate 85. Stem rather than a long. Still the same flight though.
60.
He's already had the 170. Looking now for a ton 40. May well find it to leave Klaassen's favourite double.
100, the earlier record 170.
60-60 ball. The big fish, go on! Catch the big fish, oh!
145. Hillier requires 76.
Yes. Two now at double eight, and he hit double 16 first dart, and he hits double eight first dart as well. Has missed the ball for a long range 170, and Phil Taylor takes the lead and breaks the throw.
Full flag, Phil to throw first. Game on.
The winner of this match will play Alan Norris, the only unseeded player left in the tournament. 60. Debutant as well. What an achievement from Alan Norris. Only one Phil Taylor. There's fans all over the world.
Well, when he woke up this morning, he may well have had to check his calendar to check that it wasn't August the 13th rather than December the 30th, because it must have felt like it was his birthday after Van Gerwen went out. First of the match.
100.
So, a chance of a break back here for Klaassen, because he's 15 up plus these, and he will have the darts in the next leg if he gets there.
But he can't stay there, got to switch away.
59.
He does. Not the best of visits. But just a ton from Phil would not bother Yeller. Anything more than that would. What a time to hit your first one. What a time to hit your first one.
So the second straight leg. Klaassen's getting you some crumbs off the top table. He missed the ball for the 170. And he's missed it for the 167.
42.
Both were close, but no cigar.
Maybe. For the first set, double 18.
25.
Missed two darts for the set.
The earlier required 25.
Could be significant. Double three.
Game shot in a full flag.
Well,
Yellow Klaassen.
As you said, Wayne, he goes his own way, Yellow Klaassen. Not many pros would go 13.66 on 25.
Game on.
I can see why he does it. I don't agree with it. The 13 is there, you're on the same line, 46. There's not much movement needed. But you can do what he did, and that was leave double three. I know he hit it.
Only 46 started, Klassen.
136.
So he's in trouble again here. Here's the big bailout shot. That's the bailout, that's got the ship right in again for Klassen. Makes him favourite for the set again.
He certainly has some weapons.
140.
Jelle Klassen. Brilliant reply from Phil.
Is fantastic. Poor opening salvo followed by both barrels. And a great riposte. What a leg this is.
Yeah,
crucial leg.
95.
Excellent set. Double 19.
55.
Phil Taylor's already had two darts to win the set. Can he win it with this 88 finish?
Klassen may rue not going bull first dart there. 18 leaves that bullseye. So this set, will it be decided by a dart at bull?
63.
Well, both men have missed darts at the middle of the ball, but Klassen looking for something more manageable. Double top. It's all over. Jelle Klassen has got the first set. Phil Taylor missed three darts to take it, but the cool customer Klassen has pocketed the opening set with the darts, but that makes things interesting. Very interesting.
Phil Taylor missed two darts at double 18 to win that set 3-1. Jelle Klassen eventually winning the set himself by 3-2. 2 180s in that last leg, back to back. Perfect timing. There's never been a respecter of reputations, Jelle. There is the draw. Raymond van Barneveld is into the quarterfinals after beating Michael van Gerwen. Plays Michael Smith. Adrian Lewis plays Peter Wright, who beat Chizzy in an absolute Ali Pali classic. Gary Anderson, the world champ, will take on James Wade. Alan Norris, debutant, unseeded, made it all the way through to the quarterfinal, and he would play the winner of this match. Who will it be? Who do you fancy? Jelle Klassen, a set to the good. But Phil Taylor, has to be said, Rod, has played a lot better than we've seen previously in this competition.
Absolutely started so much better. He's started exactly the way he would have wanted to, with the exception of a couple of missed darts at double 18. Really, anyone can miss.
Second set, first leg, Phil to
But he hit double 16 and double 8 first dart. That's been a problem area for him over recent months. Going back to the final here last year, which really hurt him against Gary Anderson. He hit a maximum, 5 140s, averaged 105.
130,
so
sir.
He'll be as pleased as you can be, given that he lost the set.
140.
Well, that last set was in the balance until Jelle went max, max. Very good. And they're very good, aren't they? They're not average, are they?
Second maximum from Phil Taylor in just the sixth leg of the match. Mind you, hit seven against Kevin Painter, in fairness, in a match that only lasted five sets. Four of them were in the last couple of sets as his game improved. Yes, pitching perfectly. Ideal.
140.
Very good leg here, leaving 44 after nine. Not much that Klassen can do about this.
60 for the 44.
12. 32.
Well, he misses twice, but on an occasion when he had plenty of time. Klassen is still not on a finish here. He is now.
81. Do we require 16?
Well, he's there eventually, fourth dart, and there's a bit of scowling going on from the power. It's a leg which he completely bossed by his big scoring. So he could afford to miss a few.
41.
Yeah, his scoring was phenomenal in that leg. Left 44 after just nine darts.
84. 55.
Maybe Jelle Klassen. It's a bit warm for him, blowing the fingers. A bit sweaty. And as you can see, Jelle Klassen, there's a fan 100. By the side of the stage, and Jelle made a beeline for it. Maybe just feeling the heat up there. He's a fit, young, strong man.
134.
Just wants to cool his body down a sec. Let's just see if he goes back over there again to cool down. No, not that time.
140.
Phil Taylor's scoring tonight. So much better. And it's not just the numbers that he's scoring. It's the where the darts are going. The first dart, either on the bottom wire or just below it, which is where he wants to place it.
171.
That leaves a ton, though, for Klassen. And a magical 171.
Brilliant shot. Every pro loves a ton finish, 60 tops, even though Phil's applied maximum pressure. Tops. Double 10.
90. Do we require 40?
Well, he pulled the trigger twice but couldn't find the target. So tops for Taylor for a 2-0 cushion in this second set. And he's there. He breaks the Klassen throw. Well on the way now to levelling up the match at one apiece.
Well,
the leg Phil to throw first.
I'm not sure what Phil is eyeballing Jelle for. But only confident men want confrontation.
Easy one.
When they think they've got the beating of you. That's my experience on the dartboard. Maybe Phil fences it. Maybe there was some noise when Phil was throwing and he thought it was Jelle. We don't know.
140.
Well, absolutely evident that belief has returned to Phil Taylor's game. Swagger about him now, a confidence. An average of 107.5. And only someone qualified with sports psychology would be able to tell you if that's due to Michael van Gerwen losing, but it could only have a positive effect, couldn't it? It couldn't have a negative effect. He must have felt good about that. Van Gerwen is the man who's caused him so much problems, his nemesis over the last 12 months and more.
We'll all be pleased. Gary Anderson. Rubbing his hands to get it together. Adrian Lewis.
140.
All champions. Phil was averaging 112 in this set.
140.
He wants tops to wrap it up. Phil Taylor. wins the second set. Clearly. Did he just say I'm back? Did you just say I'm back? If the belief is back, the game's back, this championship maybe could be Phil Taylor's after all. Do not write the great man off. 1-1. Welcome back to the World Darts Championship. Phil Taylor wins that second set. That is the stride of a man who is confident, who has regained his composure, who has regained his self-belief, who maybe just believes he can be world champion for the 17th time. We shall find out. Peter Wright beats Dave Chisnell 4-3 in another quality game. Alan Norris beats Mark Webster 4-1, took his chances well. Mark Webster missing too many doubles, 24 darts at a doubles missed, cost him dearly. One set apiece here. Yella took the first set, Phil levelled it with a set average of 112.73. We've spoken so often about Phil Taylor lacking confidence. Well, we shall say it no more. The Taylor strut is back.
In that set, he averaged 112, and his overall average is 108, Phil Taylor. Remember, Michael van Gerwen's 109 and changed, the highest average of this tournament. That would be something, wouldn't it? If Michael van Gerwen were to go out and then Phil Taylor were to topple that average as well the day after.
The highest average ever in the world, 111.21. This man against Shane Burgess in 2002. If you're watching, Shane, Happy New Year to you, my man.
Oh, 60.
Well, he's throwing confidently. Klassen has got to erode that confidence by rattling in some big scores, taking out finishes, and indicating that he's in no mood to roll over. Just crank the pressure up on Phil Taylor, sow the seeds of doubt.
Well, Yella Klassen missed two darts at a double in the final leg. It turned out to be the final leg of the last set. Got to take your opportunities. Averaging 101, not doing a lot wrong. Phil will be looking to leave 28. If not, a nice little 68. 108, Phil.
60.
Well, the conventional way is treble 70. 10 or treble 18. Who knows what Yella Klassen... Well, treble 14 for double 14. Yes, how obvious.
In the first leg, Yella Klassen.
Now that second leg, Phil, is an orthodox as it gets, obviously, and it's another one that might just insert a little bit of doubt in the Phil Taylor head. Doesn't matter which way you choose to go, as long as it goes. Could have gone bull double 10. Wouldn't have mattered. As long as he hits the doubles.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Number four for Yella. He's just so capable, isn't he? Reached the quarterfinal here in 2009. Lost 5-1 to RVB. Did Yella Klassen.
100.
Go on.
Oh. 135.
This is on the Phil Taylor throw. That's the important thing. Well, Phil Taylor clearly put off by someone in the crowd. And because he's put off, been put off, he stopped. And because he stopped, the crowd are getting on his back and booing.
knows what was said and by whom.
97 for your record, 161.
Displeased the power, but he's back looking at 161 here. Just too high, and Glasson will be back for 89 to go two up.
97
in the third set. 89. Treble 19 would be my guess. Yes, clean kill and two darts. A bit like the 70 in the last leg. Oh, applause. Applause from the 16 times world champion.
To throw first. Game on.
Interesting. What do you make of that?
I just don't know what to make of Phil Taylor these days anyway. Turns up
140.
Turns up one night and plays like me. Turns up the next night and plays like Phil Taylor.
Well, this Sunnyzal board of 17 and three quarter inches diameter has 20 radial segments, and Jelle Klaassen is using most of them.
45.
There's sometimes in Jelle Klaassen's play a reluctance to switch that I personally can't fathom out. Because he's a very good cover shooter. Sometimes he does. Well, he's not going down for cover here.
135.
Even if he hit a single 20, he wouldn't have left to finish there, would he?
99.
Anyway. Right. 181 Klaassen after 9. Scratchy trip to the hockey here.
85. Rectifies it. 167.
Well, he took this out in his first round match against Kita Ono. Not to be seen this time.
Well, the 96, the Dutch starting delight. Barney's match shot against MBG. Will it be the set winning shot for Jelle Klaassen? Incredible double-double!
58. Who you require?
I would say there's probably one player in this 72-man field that would go double-19 with 76 on offer and two darts in hand. Phil Taylor looking at double-8.
Well, the set has become competitive again. Because now Phil Taylor has the darts.
Game on.
Got to switch. They're just going in so much better, aren't they?
134.
They really are. It's been spoken about so often about the mental state of Phil Taylor. How the players are not frightened of him anymore and how fragile of mind he's been. Well, you can't be that fragile of mind if you can somehow improve so drastically over a few days. You've got to believe.
Brilliant again. Klaassen's had four maximums in this match already.
100.
But if he cannot break the Phil Taylor throw here, it'll come down to a really pivotal leg, which will be leg 5 in the third set. Much depending on it.
97.
If it goes that far.
Phil Taylor had darts to win the first set, lost it. Jelle has already had a dart to win this set. Number 5.
170.
He had this in the last match against Kevin Painter. He won't get it in this one at the moment, Phil Taylor, but what a setup. Leaving chops.
May go 25 route. Oh, conventional Jelle.
53. Phil,
so, tops for Phil Taylor to tie up the set and really set things twitching. Double 10 then now. Oh, double five. And three 30. Darts have come and three have Phil gone. Now, Jelle Klaassen. Now is the time.
36. He's going the That leaves double 18. Jelle Klassen wins the third set. Quality finish. In that set, Jelle Klassen took out finishes of 70, 89, and that's 68. Yes, they're not ton plus finishes, but let me tell you, if you keep taking those out, you're going to give yourself a great chance of winning.
34.
Because invariably, when you're the quality of player that's on show in this World Championship, you're going to be on them after 12 darts.
134.
Jelle Klassen, 103.69. Phil Taylor, 106.38. Quality this year is simply incredible. It's better and better each year.
100.
Oh, magnetic darts.
170.
The confidence of the Cobra. The class of Klassen. I like the way he's going about his business, Jelle Klassen. He's not interested in what Phil Taylor's doing. Everything's a routine, isn't it? Back to his table, and his hands mocked up. Nice and moist, ready to throw again. Lovely. What a lovely leg of darts to leave 28 after 9. Superb.
Well, all these unconventional setup shots, they might be, but I'll tell you what.
140.
He's hitting what he's going for, Jelle Klassen. Absolutely superb. 190 and 4 darts.
Second leg, Jelle to throw first. Game on.
Well, he's averaging stratospheric stuff that he's never done before in a World Championship match.
59.
102.5 against Joe Cullen in the first round, Jelle, his best World Championship average. So you can see he's raised his game to new heights.
64.
And at the moment, it's great stuff. It's given him the lead.
Phil Taylor just starting 60. To hit a few ropey scores. Pressure telling.
Well, the point I was making a couple of sets back, Klassen had to make Phil Taylor start to doubt himself because he swaggered off stage after set two, and Klassen had to make him think, and he has made him think, hasn't he?
Well, he's produced. He's produced at the right time.
96.
That'll work. Looking to break straight back.
Oh. Jelle Klassen had other ideas, and that 180 was the best of them. A look of confusion crept across the features of the 16 times champion. He's wondering what Klassen is still doing up there. He thinks that he could have blown Klassen out of the auditorium with what he was doing in the first two. Not a bit of it.
51 ball. This performance from Jelle Klassen, the way he's going about doing things, 190 in four darts, hitting a 180 from a seemingly lost leg. It's a bit Michael van Gerwen-like. Seems to be beaten in the leg and then just pulls out brilliance.
2-8, Phil Taylor. Well, despite all that from Klassen, Phil Taylor keeps his composure, keeps his confidence. Levels up this set. That was with a break of throw, remember? What a great game this is, the ebb and flow. Klassen throwing everything at Phil Taylor, who'd been throwing everything at the Dutchman in the first couple of sets. The crowd rising to the power.
Phil's going to miss, he wants it there.
100.
The seventh.
The
speed coupled with the accuracy.
Only 96, if you're looking at two trebles in this visit.
Well, the exact opposite has happened, in fact. The exact 31. Opposite has happened, to the relief of Phil Taylor, no doubt, who leads by 24 plus these. As you said, Wayne, a couple of big trebles there would have put Phil Taylor bang under it. Can he stack? Yes.
100.
Similar scenario, though, two big trebles.
Indeed.
140.
He's 92. A very gettable 92. Phil Taylor going for the 19s. Now a single 19. Double 16.
76.
Well, ball or treble 20, but who knows what Yeller's got in his box of tricks. Two at double 16, one at double 16. All he needs, Yeller Klassen breaks the throw. He's throwing for a three, sets to one advantage.
Full flag Yeller to throw first, game on.
Yeller Klassen is averaging 108 in this set. Some of his finishing.
47.
Well, he's looking at his hands. I'm expecting him to go over to the fan here and just have a little cool down. And there he is, standing right there. It even wants it underneath his shirt. It's so much warmer this year because of the weather, obviously, but more people.
96.
Yeah, I don't know if he's sweaty fingers that perspiration in the tension. The tension really mounts here. Everyone knows the importance. Hush at the Ali Pali.
Phil Taylor may not be the world number one, he may not be the world champion, but
86.
It's still a big story when he gets beat in a world championship. It's still a big story when someone is leading him in a world championship 60. Match. This is his 27th world championship. He's made the final 20 times and won 16 of them. It's an incredible record.
Three times the winner here. 9, 10 and latterly 13 as Klassen looks to hunt down number 8 in terms of maximums, but a 14th 140 does leave a shot. So he's coming back for treble 20, treble 19, double 19.
59. Yeller Klassen 155.
The way Yeller Klassen is scoring, Phil Taylor cannot relax at all, at any point in any leg.
55.
Leaves 100.
Phil Yeller Klassen 160.
Can Phil Taylor pull this rabbit out of the hat? Another there, and that is sitting perfectly. And that is a surprise and a disappointment to
80.
Phil Taylor.
Yeller Klassen 100.
Well, I've no idea what he was going for with the last dart. He lost his mind. Tops now. Phil Taylor was nodding behind when that 60 went in. Double 10.
90.
Well, he's missed that same shot. Exactly
80.
The same segments as before.
Well, he stopped his rhythm. He's all about rhythm. And when he stops, things change. And now the double 10 could be Phil Taylor's friend. Or double 4, up you go. But
72.
Not in you go.
Here you require 10.
Nothing is that simple for Phil Taylor at the moment, is it? For another set, for his third set. Yeller Klassen.
6.
May.
Who you require?
Just
mate. 8.
We've blown this set.
Double four. Level set. Four darts double. At double missed by Jelle Klassen. Note them down.
The flag, Phil to throw first. Game on.
Note them well. Were they the darts that cost Jelle Klassen? We won't know for some time. He could still win this set, clearly. But Phil Taylor has not lost it. Could have been going off stage, 3-1 behind Wayne.
Definitely not playing as well.
48.
Phil Taylor as he was for the first 2.5 sets. Everything is just hard work, even the 80, it's the 60, and then it's double six, and it becomes a bit messy.
140.
Well, they've both had 20 darts at a double each, and both hit eight.
100.
Well, he needed more than that, you feel. Phil Taylor closing in on the match-levelling leg.
140.
In a really tense, tense match, tense night. The last darting night of 2015.
140. Do you require 138?
For the set and a level match, 60. Will go 54. Double 12.
140.
Well, was that faux anger? Because he knows he must be content. He must be content because he knows he's coming back for three more at double 12. He missed outside. That was the right thing to do. Now to level the match on the target. He just missed once. In it goes. In it goes. And this match is now level. Phil Taylor could be forgiven for going off stage, whistling the theme from The Great Escape, because he could so easily have been 3-1 down. Four darts for the double, for the set missed by Jelle Klassen, and the power pounced to level this match at 2-4.
Welcome back, Phil Taylor. Escapes and makes it 2 sets apiece. It's a game full of tension. And during it, Phil finds the need to impersonate some kind of clown or something. What are you doing, Phil? You've lost your mind, man. Some kind of mime artist. But he's happy, and that's all he cares about. 2-2. Peter Wright won one of the best games we have seen, not far short of the one we saw from MVG and RVB the other night. Chizzy, unlucky to lose, had a dart to win. Alan Norris beats Mark Webster 4-1. Webby missing doubles. 2 apiece here, but Jelle Klassen really, really should be 3-1 up. He will be livid, Phil would be pleased. That's sport.
I think he might have been an imaginary horse, like Mark Woods, the England cricketer. He gallops around on an imaginary horse on the outfield. Maybe that was it. You've got to release the tension somehow. And there is plenty of tension round this magnificent sporting arena tonight. Rest assured. Started off as the best of 7 sets, now effectively the best of 3 sets. Jelle Klassen missed 4 darts at double for the 4th set. Could have had a 2-set cushion to sit back on. But it hasn't deterred the dynamic Dutchman, has it?
Well, he's such an instinctive player. And when he has missed, it's And he's just taken his time a bit too long.
55.
Thinking about it. Don't think about this yellow, just do it. Just do the nine.
Yes.
Far away, was it? Could have become, or looking to become, the third Dutchman to hit a nine dart finish on this very stage.
100.
Along with Raymond van Barneveld and Michael van Gerwen. It's a slip, but he started 165 in front.
81.
You're going to hit a one. Hit it when you are that far in front, indeed. Phil coming back from the set. Coming
85.
Back from the break to play in this set a bit slowly. But it's on the class and throw, so no harm done. Not again, he's not going to go inside again, is he? Oh, inside the double 10 this time. Third time lucky off the straight ton for Jelle Klassen. And each time he's hit that 60 first dart.
Well, it was that very, very shot, the 100, wasn't it, that he missed that effectively cost him the set. He hit the 60, then he went inside, didn't he? Then got in a pickle on double five.
The first dart at double 100. Five was an absolute gem. That's where, if he's going to miss it, that's where he would have wanted the first dart.
Well, he went from diamonds to rocks, though, didn't he, with his next dart, double five.
140.
But I tell you what, there's an unflappable, unbreakable confidence about Jelle Klassen. Just see. It was the way he was talking, wasn't it? He was talking Phil Taylor down, wasn't 60. He, before the match, saying he's not playing as confidently as he was, he's not playing as well. Very few players would take that step to talk their opponent down.
140.
Shows an extraordinary level of confidence going into the match.
Well, you've got to remember that Jelle Klassen is a man that, on his World Championship debut, beat Raymond van Barneveld in the final. He's got it.
Yeah.
Whatever it is to be champion, he's got it.
Point is, we're not just talking about darts players. Most sportsmen will trot out some flannel about their opponent being the greatest player on earth and how they're full of respect for him. Klassen wasn't interested in trotting out platitudes. Interesting.
Flannel, I like that.
He's left 132. We might see the old circus shot, bull 32.
100. Nearly 132.
Here, start on the 60. 96 leaves 36. 96. Good setup play.
Favourite double left. We haven't seen too much of the double 18 from Jelle Klassen in this match. In the Mervyn King game, seems like almost every leg he was eyeing up.
D18.
Double nine now. And that is no bother to the Cobra, who now has a two-leg cushion in this set. He wins it, Phil Taylor will be forced to take out the final two sets to go through.
Game on.
Phil's just not got his wits about him. He's saying well done and he's going to throw when it's not his throw. He started off this match so well, averaging 105 in the first set, 112 in the second. Just lost his way in this set.
He started out with supreme confidence. He was finding the mark regularly. If we remember, he hit double 16 and double 8, both first dart in the first few legs. But I think he's been shaken out of his stride by the ferocity of Klassen's scoring.
And the confidence.
And the confidence.
Eight one-eighties.
140.
Not a lot to choose between them there, but the important thing is that Jelle Klassen is two legs to the good in this, the fifth set.
Well, the third set was like this, wasn't it? Klassen was two up, looked like he was coasting, suddenly Phil Taylor broke back but couldn't 60. Hold to force it into a decider. It's following a similar pattern.
Ninth.
140.
He walked with that one. Always go low when you walk. Dribble 17 to leave the ball. Go back up to leave 24.
92. The LA require 152.
Needed to find two treble 20s, but he has found one and two to set up double six.
40. Who requires 69.
And that will be for the set, unless Phil Taylor can clean up 69. And he's only going to have one dart at a double.
He's got to go, Phil. Double 16.
That's unlucky. Throw on the wire.
Yellow Klassen has gone 140-140 to leave double six.
Yellow Klassen leads Phil Taylor 3-2 in a race to 4-sets match. Phil Taylor's dreams of a 17th world title are hanging by a thread. Has to win this set on his darts, first and foremost. But he's under pressure like he's never been under in this year's tournament. Didn't get put under pressure by Keita Ono, and Kevin Paynton missed too many darts at double at the start of the match to get him under the cosh in that second round game. Klassen is a different kettle of fish.
140.
Superb.
140.
Jelle Klassen, before a dart was thrown at this World Championship, was mentioned as a possible outsider for it. Well, he's not an outsider now, is he?
Well, he is certainly the most likely winner of this darts match. If you don't believe me, believe a bookmaker. Because they now make Klassen 2-5 to put Taylor out. He's got to hit treble 18. Oh, and again he's unlucky. Nearly squeezed it in the bottom corner, but the bottom line is Klassen's got a break chance.
16. Double 9.
72. Do you require 68?
No gimme.
May only get one dart at double. Tops is the target.
28.
And he has missed.
Nine.
And Jelle Klassen now is eyeing up the break on double two. And he has hit double two. And there is a nonchalant nod, a confident nod from the former Lakeside world champion, the youngest ever world champion.
Jelle Klassen has said in an interview this week that maybe he won the
83
World Championships when he was too young. And then he offered, "I'm such a better player now." When you are full of confidence like that,
130,
it's going to make it hard to beat. And he certainly believes he can win.
96.
He has got to dig to his very deepest here. He's got to dig to the very bottom drawer of his darting experience. But the problem is that Klassen is unrelenting. Will he wobble? Will there be some case of clincher's disease for Klassen that Phil Taylor can exploit? No sign of it at the moment, Wayne.
It's a brilliant leg of darts. Under extreme pressure, withstanding it at the moment. But that
134.
Is just another 87. Score that is... These are all hurting Phil Taylor constantly.
Well, everyone in this auditorium feels that if he misses this finish, he's in utter peril. Brilliant! Brilliant clutch dart at double five. Klassen was on a two dart combination and he still has it, Phil Taylor. Still has the will to win. Still has the darting determination to stay alive in the 2016 World Championship. Klassen asked plenty of questions there, Wayne, and Phil Taylor had the answer.
12 dart leg.
180.
And then starts 180.
57.
Well, shades last year of Gary Anderson.
100.
Who took out 84 on the bull against Jelle Klaassen when he was on the brink of defeat. Phil Taylor taking out 87 when he was on the brink 60. Of defeat against Klaassen.
Same round.
Same round.
190.
Well, you have to wonder in awe, don't you? A man on the brink of defeat,
98.
With Klaassen playing brilliantly, 41. Goes out in 12 darts, last dart in hand, hits maximums, and now looks out to go out in 11 darts. And even in 12 or even 15 will be fine, because Klaassen's not on a finish. He's done enough damage in this leg, you feel.
No damage in missing, but it's just another two darts that he
requires 32.
He's gaining no confidence from. Doesn't want to be messing around.
Game short in the third leg.
Well, there was a little bit of messing around, but it was irrelevant messing around, because in the end the leg is won. 2-1 to Phil Taylor. But back comes the Cobra! His 10th of the match.
Quality game. Another quality game. It's been riddled with them, this World Championships.
96.
Last night we saw the former world champion, a world number one, Michael van Gerwen, eliminated. Tonight we're watching Phil Taylor put through the ringer by Jelle Klaassen, hanging on, trying to take it to a deciding set here.
140.
But it looks like going to a deciding leg, one that Phil Taylor will have to win on his own throw.
He only required 85.
57 or 45? Double 14.
57.
Well, a bit like Phil in the last leg. No damage.
There will be a bit more pressure, won't there? Because Phil Taylor on his second try at double wasn't under any pressure. Klaassen still wasn't on a finish, but Taylor will be here.
And it's to save the set as well for Jelle.
140. You require 28.
This is to send it into a deciding leg. That's the problem with double 14. That's not the problem with double 7. 2-2. And now suddenly, the most important leg of darts that Phil Taylor has played for a calendar year. Everything he works for is about world championships. If he doesn't win this leg, he is out of this one.
100.
Well, the first dart was perfect. Only a ton. Jelle Klaassen. He's already hit 10 maximums.
59.
He would love one in this leg.
44.
I was surprised. I thought he'd switch down for treble 19. He obviously felt he could still hit the treble 20, but Klaassen has not hit a big treble in this leg at all. Now he has. 10 points in it.
Well, Phil has dodged a bullet there. If you start 144, you're normally away behind. Is it all getting too much?
41.
Well, he has tried to call on every ounce of composure, but he has not been able to find a treble. And now, Jelle Klassen is piling it on. Only one treble. Could have been worse for Phil Taylor, but Klassen now sniffing victory. Sniffing the scalp of the greatest Arrowsmith ever.
It really is a
100.
A feeling around this auditorium now that this really is getting so, so serious for Phil Taylor.
Brilliant darts to leave double 18, but the nail biting continues. The tension is ratcheted up for the match. Double 18 to knock Phil Taylor out of the World Darts Championship. That is how close it was. Had that gone in, Phil Taylor has gone. And now on the very same double, the very same double.
Angel to the sixer.
Three sets apiece as Jelle Klassen. A little fist pump.
Final set first, it's nice. Jelle to throw first. Game on.
Jelle Klassen. He's had a dart at double 18 to beat the 16-time champion of the world and to book a place in the quarterfinals. Will that be the only chance he gets? This is one of those sports you just never know.
Well, maybe Phil Taylor's mind wandering back to 1992 when Mike Gregory missed all those match darts against him and still remains the only man to miss match darts in a final and not win one, but he escaped then, he's escaped one here, and he's taking full advantage!
180.
Nine darts into the previous leg, Phil looked like he'd lost the ability to throw tungsten at a dartboard. Now, it was four darts into a nine. Staying there. Now for a treble 20.
58.
Jelle Klassen now is the one in a bit of trouble.
It was a fraction of an inch away from winning, Jelle Klassen.
96.
Almost took out 147. And if you said before the match you can have one dart at your favourite double 18 to knock him out, you'd have said thank you very much, don't play the match.
126.
I'll have a go at it. 19's here. Single for ball. Treble for double six. Ball! Wow! The 126 out! On the ball, his biggest finish of the match, the biggest finish of the match. Is it the key finish of the match?
Jelle Klassen does second not look that confident now, does he? He looks absolutely gobsmacked. In the last three and a bit minutes, you've seen Jelle Klassen miss a dart, a double for the match. Phil Taylor start the next leg with a 180 and then finish it with a 126 finish on the bullseye.
100.
The darting drama continues. Phil Taylor is in front for the first time.
Out
80.
Well, it just didn't cling on really, did it? More of a fallout than a bounce out. just tried to cling on. Still got a big lead in this leg.
74.
The 1-2-6 out shot. The double 18 that Phil Taylor hit. The double 18 that Jelle Klaassen missed. Darts had doubly missed for a set earlier. You can take your pick of all those turning points. But it seems to have turned Phil Taylor's way.
Yeah, well, only hitting 58 there. Jelle Klaassen really has missed the trick. A 140 would have given him a super opportunity. And he took out 1-2-6. Now, can he take out the 1-2-3? A single 9 will leave 32. 91.
Well, is that one last act of darting defiance or something more significant?
Do we require 32?
500th of the tournament. Taylor wants double 16. Phil Taylor, who was one dart away from defeat 5 minutes ago, is now one leg away from victory.
100.
Jelle Klaassen, he's under it. Can he cope?
57.
Missing that double 18 to win the match, and missing it seems to have changed the demeanour, the mindset of the former BDO world champ.
Is he still throwing that double 18 at that double 18 in his mind? He just 60. Hasn't been able to recompose himself at all, has he, for whatever reason.
Phil Taylor's next shot was a 180.
Yes.
And no time to settle. Then he got down to
137.
Finishing that leg and then took out the 1-2-6. It was just the timing of Phil Taylor in this last set. It's been perfect. Absolute perfect.
40.
Cannot write him off.
164.
Alan Norris awaits in the quarterfinals. Is this the final shot? It will not be the final shot, but will it be the ideal setup for the power? That will do very nicely. He was on the brink of defeat. He's on the brink of victory now.
180!
Amazing.
Who you require? 64.
For the match. Didn't seem likely, did it? How many times has he hit this in his career?
24. Yeah, you require 64.
Last chance saloon. Tops. And there is still someone serving at the bar in the last chance saloon. Jelle Klaassen survives. He's got to break Phil Taylor's throw. Both players now have missed a dart for the match.
Klaassen missed double 18. Phil Taylor missed the tops.
100.
This tournament just keeps on delivering, doesn't it? Delivering darting drama. Oh, he's in again. He's in again. Unlucky 13 for Phil.
Incredible. Twice, you could be forgiven for thinking the match was over.
30.
Once in Klaassen's favour, once in Phil Taylor's favour. Now it looks different, doesn't it? Now it looks very different because suddenly, from somewhere, Jelle Klaassen has made the most of his reprieve.
36.
Just wants a treble. With 62. No wayward darts. That's opened the door.
He can't leave, well, he hasn't left a finish, which is incredible to think. It would have been better if that had bounced out than hitting the one. It would have left 160.
96.
Anyway, Phil Taylor has not left a finish anyway. Goodness me.
23.
Goodness me, after a dozen darts, Klassen has left that double 18 again. The one he missed to win the match in the previous set.
Well, that was Phil Taylor's 100. First kind of bad miscount setup. And it happens in that situation when he's under extreme pressure.
The tie break. Standing at two legs, who in the final set, the match must now be won by two clear legs. Should the leg score reach five legs, all the 11th leg will be sudden death. Fifth leg, yellow to throw first.
This game is on. Where there is a slight advantage in throwing first. And remember, Jelle Klassen was invited to throw first at the start of this darts match by Phil Taylor. And he's accepted that invitation. Got a win by two legs, as George Noble was saying, the referee, unless it goes 91. To five each, and then it will be a sudden death leg. Klassen was on the canvas. He looked like he was going to be carried out. Phil Taylor was one down at tops. Klassen went out and then broke back.
Amongst it all, they've both held it together extremely 60. Well.
Talk about the games we've seen in the last 24 hours here. Van Gerwen against Barneveld, Chisnell and Wright, and now this to cap it all. The greatest name 100. In the game, on the brink against the classy Dutchman. Double 10 for Jelle Klassen to lead in the tiebreak. Now it's all back on the shoulders of Phil Taylor.
He has been involved in some classics throughout the years. This is just full of so much tension now. As Phil Taylor hits his 24th 140. And Jelle Klassen hits his 15th 180. Oh my.
Come up dry. He's come up dry. And Jelle Klassen is running hot. Red hot.
25.
Jelle Klassen is at 4 180s in the last five legs. I don't know what you're smiling for, Phil.
Well, a hush as the crowd wondered whether that third dart was in. It wasn't. Which gives Klassen half a dozen from here. What a leg he's played here. What a leg Jelle Klassen has played.
Jelle Klassen has hit seven treble 20s in nine darts in the leg 71. To beat Phil Taylor in the World Championship.
Double 10, it's all over! Jelle Klassen has put out the greatest darts player of all time. He ends the dream for this year of a 17th world title for the power. What an incredible match. Jelle Klassen missed the match start. Phil Taylor then missed the match start. But Klassen has kept his cool and his composure to move into the quarterfinals. Warm congratulations from Phil Taylor. But deep down, he will be devastated. Devastated. The dream of a 17th world title is over for 2016. For Klassen, the quarterfinals awaits.
First it was Van Gerwen, now the power, out of the Palace. Quarter-final draw looks like this, Gary Anderson against James Wade. No Taylor, it will be Alan Norris who takes on Jelle Klassen. Raymond van Barneveld, Michael Smith, and Adrian Lewis against Peter Snape by Wright. What a night of darts we've had here at the Palace. Phil Taylor is out. Reaction from Wayne Mardle. What a match. What a performance from Klassen.
All of it's just kind of overwhelming, don't you think? It's just drama after drama, and it gets to the point of what on earth is going on? They're all so closely matched. They really are. And I think we kind of knew that, but now with Michael gone, Phil gone, you just get the feeling that things are changing within the world of darts. No one anymore, absolutely no one, has the upper hand day in, day out. We know Michael van Gerwen has just been relentless, absolutely relentless. But on the world stage, everyone's beatable. The performance we saw from Peter Wright and Dave Chisnell, it's just game after game, and just full of tension. Every game is just full of it. It's great.
The fear factor has gone now, hasn't it? Everybody thinks they can beat everybody else.
Yes.
Makes for a great world championship.
There used to be a point when it would be, well, he's experienced, he'll win. He's won this, so therefore he's got the upper hand. None of it. There's none of that anymore. They're all so capable. They all practice so hard. They've all got management. They've all got people with them.
Wayne, we can hear from Jelle Klassen now, talking to Rod Studd.
Jelle, congratulations, what a match and what a victory for you. Just some about your feeling for us, please.
Ooh, I almost gave that away. I missed too many darts to go 3-1 in front. And you know, Phil, you can't miss against Phil. Then I missed a 1-4-7 for the match, and he made 3-all. And then he started brilliant. He checked a 1-2-6 for the first leg to break me. But I never give up. I felt like I could still win the game. He missed one dart to win on 64. I checked 64, so over the moon.
In all honesty, did you think when you'd missed that double 18 and he went two legs up in the next set that your chance had gone?
No, but when he broke me the first leg of the last set, I thought, now it's going to be difficult. But I hit a lot of 180s, and that saved me a couple of times. And like I said, I didn't give up. I kept on fighting and put him under pressure, and I'm happy that I won.
You've played many great legs over your career. You've won the World Championship at the Lakeside. But I just want to know, what's that last leg that was the winning leg, the best leg of darts you've ever played? I think you hit 7 treble 20s in the first 9 darts.
Yeah, I think I had an 11-dart leg to win the game against Phil. So it's always the feeling to beat Phil on this stage is special. But it's just one game. I've got another game in 2 days, so I'm not going to be too happy because I want to win the next game as well, but this feels brilliant.
You seem incredibly more confident than you were, say, 2 or 3 years ago. What's changed, Jelle?
I changed my throw. I practice a lot, and I think all the times that everybody beat me, it made me stronger, and I think the last year I've become a better player. But I know I can do better, but I'm happy with this performance.
You've every right to be. Look, you're through to the quarterfinals. You'll play Alan Norris. We look forward to seeing you on New Year's Day. Well played tonight, Jelle. Well done.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thanks, Jelle.
He was confident before the match. He oozes confidence in that interview as well. Those are the stats. 102.523 to average. The key, the 15-180s, Wayne Mardle from Klassen.
Well, yeah, the people say that 180s don't win matches, but they certainly help, I'll tell you. There wasn't many legs that he was out of being outscored anyway, but when he was 100, 120 behind and he banged in one of his 15 180s, you could physically see Phil look on in amazement, thinking, here we go again. He never had any respite in hardly any of the legs because Jelle always put a big one in. And if you can do that, like I said in commentary, it was Van Gerwen-like, where every single leg there was a big shot going in. So there's just no time to think, right, okay, if I can set this up and then go out, that'll be fine. You're always under pressure, and in the end it was Jelle that held it together. Phil was, he was very, very good at the start, and then kind of tapered off in the middle and got better again. The inconsistency is still there, but it was a better performance from Phil Taylor, just not good enough.
He had a dart to win it.
He did, yeah. He wanted 64. He hit the 16, then a single 8, and that's the tops. And
the margins of success and failure are so fine, aren't they?
It was like you had a Klassen with a 147 to get it done a lot earlier. The 60, the 51, the double 18 was a good dart. It just didn't go in. Sometimes, look, that's the way it is. But he got his chance, and as he said, he stuck in. He stuck in, but this is some tournament. It's just incredible with all the upsets. And that was an upset. Phil Taylor was a 1-5 or 1-6 favourite.
Can he stay on course for number 17? That's the question on everybody's lips in here. This is what we've seen so far tonight, an absolute classic match. Peter Wright coming through an amazing game with Dave Chisnell, 4-3. Alan Norris will play the winner of our final match of the evening. He beat Mark Webster 4-1. And next, the world champions collide, Phil Taylor against Jelle Klassen. Draw looks like this. Gary Anderson against James Wade. Alan Norris will take on the winner of Phil Taylor against Jelle Klassen. The match you're about to see now. Top half of the draw, Barney against Michael Smith. Adrian Lewis against Peter Snakebite Wright. Wayne Miles alongside with a sort of a calm before the storm. Everybody expectant, but wondering what Taylor is going to turn up tonight.
Well, yeah, I just think that Phil is now one of these players that you're not too sure how he's going to play. He used to be Mr. Reliable, always more or less around the 100 average. I think if he's anywhere near that, I think he'd take care of Jelle. Jelle was far too inconsistent, really was, in his last match against against Mervyn King. First round match was superb, the highest of the first round, but that is Jelle Klassen. Averages 102, then 92. I cannot in any way see Phil Taylor playing as poor as he did against Kevin Painter. I just don't see it. He keeps on about, I was nervous. You've got to get over that at some point. You've got to. It's just, it's human nature that you get used to a situation eventually. And maybe this is the match. I'm not sure. I just find Phil really hard to read at the moment.
Let's find out. We'll chat more in a moment. Let's get this match up and running. Taylor is coming next.
World title number 16 for Phil Taylor.
Damn.
He wouldn't give the blob of his sweat to a man dying of thirst.
We are live on Sky Sports, and a very special welcome to the millions of viewers joining us around the world. And now, it's time to meet the players. Firstly, would you please welcome from the Netherlands, the former Lakeside champion, the Cobra,
we
one we've been waiting for at Sky Sports Darcy. What are your predictions now? The crowd of fever pitch singing Taylor's name. Will his dreams of a 17th world title come to an end before the quarterfinals? Or can he book a place in the last eight against Alan Norris? Wayne Miles alongside Rod Studd in commentary. Wayne, was there a bit more of a spring in the Taylor step tonight?
I think so, Dave. There's even a little smirk on his face. He definitely looks happier. Maybe it is because of the demise of Michael van Gerwen, beaten by Raymond van Barneveld yesterday. Or maybe he just feels better. Maybe Phil Taylor is going to bring his practice game onto the World Championship stage, which is what he hasn't done yet. But I thought it was really interesting that Jelle Klassen mentioned that Phil Taylor doesn't seem secure in himself. Has that fear factor gone? Phil Taylor is still a threat, is still a potential winner, as is this man, Jelle Klassen, the 2006 BDO World Champion.
97.
Klassen invited to go first. The characteristics of Phil Taylor's first two matches against Keita Ono and Kevin Painter were
100.
Erratic starts, where he was averaging in the 80s, followed by superb finishes where he was averaging over 100 in the 60. Last couple of sets of both those matches. What will happen tonight? Well, that's an ideal start.
99.
Well, these two have one thing in common. They both won the World Championship on their debut. Phil Taylor in 1990.
2006.
I haven't played in a competitive match since February this year. Just a tour event, best of 11 legs that Jelle Klassen won 6-2. Before that, the last meeting was 2010. So really, no relevant form to go by.
Must stay there, you would think.
50.
Well, Jelle Klassen, all things being equal, will get first shot at a double in this match. All the money for Jelle Klassen today to win this match. Backed into 5-2 from 7-2 to knock Phil Taylor out as he leaves.
52.
Double 12.
Another 60. Oh, is he staying there? Yes.
140. Only required 24. A shot in the
first leg to Jelle Klassen. We saw Phil Taylor against Kevin Painter find it really hard to settle. Thought his darts were going in pretty well in that first leg. Maybe needs to throw them a tad harder, but
100.
Wasn't spraying them all over the place like he was against Kevin.
99. Managed to find a way through. Well, Klassen's two games, chalk and cheese. First game, breathtaking. Second game, bewildering. In terms of the quality of his play, he had the highest first round average in his first match, didn't he, against Joe Cullen. Against Mervyn King, much more steadier player. Missed a heck of a lot of doubles.
Jelle Klassen was the only man to average in three figures in the first round. Phil looks better tonight. Not because he's hit 260s, they're going in better. Throwing with more authority. Maybe.
140.
MVG getting beaten is just the fillip you needed.
A fillip for Philip. Fourteen.
89.
Leaves double 16. Very authoritative first leg on throw from the power. Could be a 13 dart leg. Mind you, hello.
168.
Hang on a minute.
68. Fill your required 32.
Never been conventional, is he, Yeller?
Dave Charles in the second.
First start.
Phil Taylor.
The double for Phil Taylor. Penetrates the double 16.
44.
I know it's early days, but this is as good as Phil Taylor has looked.
Started so much better than he did in his opening two ties. Even that's missing in an area where he wouldn't be too disappointed, just below the treble bed, and then following it in, something he wasn't doing in the first couple of matches also.
Yeah, the first match having terrible trouble grouping. Using different darts in the first match to what he's been using the last year or so. Change back to the Generation 2. Just an intermediate 85. Stem rather than a long. Still the same flight though.
60.
He's already had the 170. Looking now for a ton 40. And may well find it to leave Klaassen's favourite double.
100. The early record 170.
60-60 ball. The big fish, go on! Catch the big fish, oh!
145. Who you require, 76.
Well, he's looking at his hands. I'm expecting him to go over to the fan here and just have a little cool down. And there he is. Standing right there, it even wants it underneath his shirt. It's so much warmer this year because of the weather, obviously, but more people.
96.
Yeah, I don't know if his sweaty fingers that perspiration in the tension. As the tension 99. Really mounts here. Everyone knows the importance. Hush at the Ali Pali.
Phil Taylor may not be the world number one, he may not be the world champion. But 86. It's still a big story when he gets beat in a world championship. It's still a big story when someone is leading him in a world championship 60. Match. This is his 27th world championship. He's made the final 20 times and won 16 of them. It's an incredible record.
Three times 100. The winner here. 9, 10 and latterly 13 as Klaassen looks to hunt down number 8 in terms of maximums, but a 14th 140 does leave a shot. So he's coming back for treble 20, treble 19, double 19.
59.
The way Yella Klaassen is scoring, Phil Taylor cannot relax at all, at any point in any leg.
55. Leaves 100. Phil Taylor 160.
Can Phil Taylor pull this rabbit out of the hat? Another there, and that is sitting perfectly. And that is a surprise and a disappointment to
80.
Phil Taylor.
Yella Klaassen 100.
Well, I've no idea what he was going for with the last dart. He lost his mind. Tops now! Phil Taylor was nodding behind when that 60 went in. Double 10.
90.
Well, he's missed that same shot. Exactly the same segments as before.
Well, he stopped his rhythm. He's all about rhythm. And when he stops, things change. And now the double 10 could be Phil Taylor's friend. Oh, double 4, up you go! but not in you go.
Really required 10.
Nothing is that simple for Phil Taylor at the moment, is it? For another set, for his third set. Jelle Klassen.
6.
May.
Who you require?
Just May.
8.
We've blown this set.
Double 4. Level set. 4 darts double. That double missed by Jelle Klassen. Note them down.
Fifth leg, Phil to throw first. Game on.
Note them well. Were they the darts that cost Jelle Klassen? We won't know for some time. He could still win this set, clearly. But Phil Taylor has not lost it. Could have been going off stage, 3-1 behind Wayne.
Definitely not playing as well.
48.
Phil Taylor as he was for the first 2.5 sets. Everything is just hard work, even the 80, it's the 60, and then it's double six, and it becomes a bit messy.
140.
Well, they've both had 20 darts at a double each, and both hit 8.
100.
Well, he needed more than that, you feel. Phil Taylor, closing in on the match-levelling leg.
140.
In a really tense, tense match, tense night. The last darting night of 2015.
140. Do you require 138?
For the set and a level match, 60. We'll go 54. Double 12.
140.
Well, was that faux anger? Because he must be content. He must be content because he knows he's coming back for 3 more at double 12. He missed outside. That was the right thing to do. Now to level the match on the target. He just missed once. In it goes. In it goes. And this match is now level. Phil Taylor could be forgiven for going off stage, whistling the theme from The Great Escape, because he could so easily have been 3-1 down. 4 darts for the double, for the set missed by Jelle Klassen, and the power pounced to level this match at 2-4.
Welcome back, Phil Taylor. Escapes and makes it 2 sets apiece. It's a game full of tension. And during it, Phil finds the need to impersonate some kind of clown or something. What are you doing, Phil? You've lost your mind, man. Some kind of mime artist. But he's happy, and that's all he cares about. 2-2. Peter Wright won one of the best games we have seen, not far short of the one we saw from MVG and RVB the other night. Chizzy, unlucky to lose, had a dart to win. Alan Norris beats Mark Webster 4-1. Webby missing doubles. 2 apiece here, but Jelle Klassen really, really should be 3-1 up. He will be livid, Phil would be pleased. That's sport.
I think he might have been an imaginary horse, like Mark Woods, the England cricketer. He gallops around on an imaginary horse on the outfield. Maybe that was it. He's got to release the tension somehow. And there is plenty of tension round this magnificent sporting arena tonight. Rest assured. Started off as the best of 7 sets. Now, effectively, the best of 3 sets. Jelle Klaassen missed four darts at double for the fourth set. Could have had a two-set cushion to sit back on. But it hasn't deterred the dynamic Dutchman, has it?
Well, he's such an instinctive player. And when he has missed, it's... And he's just taken his time a bit too long.
Just 55.
Thinking about it. Don't think about this, Yella. Just do it. Just do the nine.
Yes.
Far away, was it? Could have become, or looking to become, the third Dutchman to hit a nine dart finish on this very stage.
100.
Along with Raymond van Barneveld and Michael van Gerwen. It's a slip, but he started 165 in front.
81.
You're going to hit a one. Hit it when you are that far in front, indeed. Phil coming back from the set. Coming back from the break to play in this set a bit slowly. But it's on the Klaassen throw, so no harm done. Not again, he's not going to go inside again, is he? Oh, inside the double 10 this time. Third time lucky. Off the straight ton for Jelle Klaassen. And each time he's hit that 60 first dart.
Well, it was that very, very shot, the 100, wasn't it, that he missed that effectively cost him the set. He hit the 60, then he went inside, didn't he? Then got in a pickle on double five.
The first dart of double 100. Five was an absolute gem. That's where, if he's going to miss it, that's where he would have wanted the first dart.
Well, he went from diamonds to rocks, though, didn't he, with his next dart, double five.
140.
But I tell you what, there's an unflappable, unbreakable confidence about Jelle Klaassen. Just see. It was the way he was talking, wasn't it? He was talking Phil Taylor down, wasn't 60. He, before the match, saying he's not playing as confidently as he was, he's not playing as well. Very few players would take that step to talk their opponent down.
140.
Shows an extraordinary level of confidence going into the match.
Well, you've got to remember that Jelle Klaassen is a man that, on his World Championship debut, beat Raymond van Barneveld in the final. He's got it.
Yeah.
Whatever it is to be champion, he's got it.
Point is, we're not just talking about darts players. Most sportsmen will trot out some flannel about their opponent being the greatest player on earth and how they're full of respect for him. Klaassen wasn't interested in trotting out platitudes. Interesting.
Flannel, I like that.
He's left 132. We might see the old circus shot, Bull 32.
100. Early record 132.
Here, start on the 60. 96 leaves 36. Good setup play.
Favourite double left. We haven't seen too much of the double 18 from Jelle Klaassen in this match. In the Mervyn King game, seems like almost every leg he was eyeing up.
D18.
Double nine now. And that is no bother to the Cobra, who now has a two-leg cushion in this set. If he wins it, Phil Taylor will be forced to take out the final two sets to go through.
Game on.
Phil's just not got his wits about him. He's saying well done and he's going to throw when it's not his throw. He started off this match so well, averaging 105 in the first set, 112 in the second. Just lost his way in this set.
He started out with supreme confidence. He was finding the mark regularly. If we remember, he hit double 16 and double 8, both first dart in the first few legs. But I think he's been shaken out of his stride by the ferocity of Klaassen's scoring.
And the confidence.
And the confidence.
Eight 180s.
140.
Not a lot to choose between them there, but the important thing is that Jelle Klaassen is two legs to the good in this, the fifth set.
Well, the third set was like this, wasn't it? Klassen was two up, looked like he was coasting. Suddenly Phil Taylor broke back, but couldn't 60. Hold to force it into a decider. It's following a similar pattern.
Ninth.
140.
They walked with that one. Always go low when you walk. Treble 17 to leave the ball. Go back up to leave 24.
92. The early require 152.
Needed to find two treble 20s, but he has found one and two to set up double six.
Who requires 69.
And that will be for the set, unless Phil Taylor can clean up 69. And he's only going to have one dart at a double.
It's got to go, Phil. Double 16. That's unlucky. Throw on the wire.
Yellow
Klassen has gone 140, 140 to leave double six.
Yellow Klassen leads Phil Taylor 3-2 in a race to 4-sets match. Phil Taylor's dreams of a 17th world title are hanging by a thread. Has to win this set on his darts, first and foremost. But he's under pressure like he's never been under in this year's tournament. Didn't get put under pressure by Keita Ono, and Kevin Paynton missed too many darts at double at the start of the match to get him under the cosh in that second round game. Klassen is a different kettle of fish.
140.
Superb.
140.
Yellow Klassen, before a dart was thrown at this World Championship, was mentioned as a possible outsider for it. Well, he's not an outsider now, is he?
Well, he is certainly the most likely winner of this darts match. If you don't believe me, believe a bookmaker. Because they now make Klassen 2-5 to put Taylor out. He's got to hit treble 18. Oh, and again, he's unlucky. Nearly squeezed it in the bottom corner, but the bottom line is Klassen's got a break chance.
16. Double 9.
72. Do you require 68?
No gimme.
May only get one dart at double. Tops is the target.
28.
And he has missed.
Nine.
And Yellow Klassen now is eyeing up the break on double two. And he has hit double two. And there is a nonchalant nod, a confident nod from the former Lakeside world champion, the youngest ever world champion.
Yellow Klassen has said in an interview this week that maybe won the
83
world championships when he was too young, and then he offered, "I'm such a better player now." When you are full of confidence like that,
130,
it's going to make you hard to beat. And he certainly believes he can win.
96.
Well, he has got to dig to his very deepest here. He's got to dig to the very bottom drawer of his darting experience. But the problem is that Klassen is unrelenting. Will he wobble? Will there be some case of clincher's disease for Klassen that Phil Taylor can exploit? No sign of it at the moment, Wayne.
It's a brilliant leg of darts. Under extreme pressure, withstanding it at the moment. But that
34.
It's just another
87.
Score that is... These are all hurting Phil Taylor constantly.
Well, everyone in this auditorium feels that if he misses this finish, he's in utter peril. Brilliant! Brilliant clutch dart at double five. Klassen was on a two-dart combination and he still has it, Phil Taylor. Still has the will to win. Still has the darting determination to stay alive in the 2016 World Championship. Klassen asked plenty of questions there, Wayne, and Phil Taylor had the answer.
12 dart leg.
180!
And then starts 180.
57.
Well, shades last year of Gary Anderson.
100.
Who took out 84 on the bull against Jelle Klaassen when he was on the brink of defeat. Phil Taylor taking out 87 when he was on the brink 60. Of defeat against Klaassen.
Same round.
Same round.
180.
Well, you have to wonder in awe, don't you? A man on the brink of defeat,
98.
With Klaassen playing brilliantly, 41. Goes out in 12 darts, last dart in hand, hits maximums, and now looks out to go out in 11 darts. And even in 12 or even 15 will be fine, oh, because Klassen's not on a finish. He's done enough damage in this leg, you feel.
No damage in missing, but it's just another two darts that he...
Who he requires, 32.
He's gaining no confidence from. Doesn't want to be messing around.
Are you short in the third leg?
Well, there was a little bit of messing around, but it was an irrelevant messing around because in the end, the leg is won. 2-1 to Phil Taylor, but back comes the cobra! His 10th of the match.
Quality game. Another quality game. It's been riddled with them, this World Championships.
96.
Last night we saw the former world champion of world number one, Michael van Gerwen, eliminated. Tonight we're watching Phil Taylor put through the ringer by Jelle Klaassen. Hanging on, trying to take it to a deciding set here.
140.
But it looks like going to a deciding leg, one that Phil Taylor will have to win on his own throw.
We only require 85.
57 or 45? Double 14.
57.
Well, a bit like Phil in the last leg. No damage.
There will be a bit more pressure, won't there? Because Phil Taylor on his second try at double wasn't under any pressure. Klaassen still wasn't on a finish, but Taylor will be here.
And it's to save the set as well for Jelle.
140. Jelle, you require 28.
This is to send it into a deciding leg. That's the problem with double 14. That's not the problem with double 7. 2-2. And now suddenly, the most important leg of darts that Phil Taylor has played for a calendar year. Everything he works for is about world championships. If he doesn't win this leg, he is out of this one.
100.
Well, the first dart was perfect. Only a ton. Jelle Klaassen. He's already hit 10 maximums.
59.
He would love one in this leg.
44.
I was surprised. I thought he'd switch down for treble 19. He obviously felt he could still hit the treble 20, but Klaassen has not hit a big treble in this leg at all. Now he has. 10 points in it.
Well, Phil has dodged a bullet there. If you start 144, you're normally away behind. Is it all getting too much?
41.
Well, he has tried to call on every ounce of composure, but he has not been able to find a treble. And now, Jelle Klassen is piling it on. Only one treble. Could have been worse for Phil Taylor, but Klassen now sniffing victory. Sniffing the scalp of the greatest Arrowsmith ever.
It really is a
100.
A feeling around this auditorium now that this really is getting so, so serious for Phil Taylor.
140. Brilliant darts to leave double 18, but the nail biting continues. The tension is ratcheted up for the match. Double 18 to knock Phil Taylor out of the World Darts Championship. That is how close it was. Had that gone in, Phil Taylor has gone. And now on the very same double, the very same double.
Three sets apiece as Jelle Klassen. A little fist pump.
Final set first, it's nice. Jelle to throw first. Game on.
Jelle Klassen has had a dart at double 18 to beat the 16-time champion of the world and to book a place in the quarterfinals. Will that be the only chance he gets? This is one of those sports you just never know.
Well, maybe Phil Taylor's mind wandering back to 1992 when Mike Gregory missed all those match darts against him and still remains the only man to miss match darts in a final and not win one, but he escaped then, he's escaped one here. And he's taking full advantage!
180.
Nine darts into the previous leg, Phil looked like he'd lost the ability to throw tungsten at a dartboard. Now, it was four darts into a nine. Staying there. Now for a treble 20.
58.
Jelle Klassen now is the one in a bit of trouble.
It was a fraction of an inch away from winning Jelle Klassen.
96.
Almost took out 147. And if you said before the match you can have one dart at your favourite double 18 to knock him out, you'd have said thank you very much, don't play the match.
126.
I'll have a go at it. 19's here. Single for ball, treble for double six. Ball! Wow! The 1-2-6 out on the ball. His biggest finish of the match, the biggest finish of the match. Is it the key finish of the match?
Jelle Klassen does second not look that confident now, does he? He looks absolutely gobsmacked in the last three and a bit minutes. You've seen Jelle Klassen miss a dart, a double for the match. Phil Taylor start the next leg with a 180 and then finish it with a 1-2-6 finish on the bullseye.
100.
The darting drama continues. Taylor is in front for the first time.
Oh, bounce out.
80.
Well, it just didn't cling on, really, did it? More of a fallout than a bounce out. Just tried to cling on. Still got a big lead in this leg.
74.
The 1-2-6 out shot. The double 18 that Phil Taylor hit. The double 18 that Jelle Klaassen missed. Darts 58. It doubly missed for a set earlier. You can take your pick of all those turning points. But it seems to have turned Phil Taylor's way.
Yeah, well, only hitting 58 there. Jelle Klaassen really has missed the trick. A 140 would have given him a super opportunity. And he took out 1-2-6. Now, can he take out the 1-2-3? A single 9 will leave 32. 91.
Well, is that one last act of darting defiance or something more significant?
Do you require 32?
500th of the tournament. Taylor wants double 16. Phil Taylor, who was one dart away from defeat 5 minutes ago, is now one leg away from victory.
100.
Yes, two now at double 8, and he hit double 16 first dart, and he hits double 8 first dart as well. Last missed the ball for a long range 170, and Phil Taylor takes the lead and breaks the throw.
Full flag, Phil to throw first. Game on.
The winner of this match will play Alan Norris, the only unseeded player left in the tournament. 60. Debutant as well. What an achievement from Alan Norris. Only one Phil Taylor. There's fans all over the world.
Well, when he woke up this morning, he may well have had to check his calendar to check that it wasn't August the 13th rather than December the 30th, because it must have felt like it was his birthday after Van Gerwen went out. First of the match. So, a chance of a break back here for Klaassen, because he's 15 up plus these, and he will have the darts in the next leg if he gets there.
But he can't stay there, got to switch away.
59.
And does. Not the best of visits. But just a ton from Phil would not bother Jelle. Anything more than that would. What a time to hit your first one. What a time to hit your first one.
So for the second straight leg, Klaassen's getting you some crumbs off the top table. He missed the ball for the 170, and he's missed it for the 167.
42.
Both were close, but no cigar.
Maybe. For the first set, double 18.
25.
Missed two darts for the set.
The only required 25.
Could be significant. Double 3.
Game charge and a full play.
Well, as you said, Wayne, he goes his own way, Jelle Klaassen. Not many pros would go 13 double 6 on 25.
Game on.
I can see why he does it. I don't agree with it. The 13 is there, you're on the same line, 46. There's not much movement needed. But you can do what he did, and that was leave double 3. I know he hit it.
Well, only 46 started. Klassen
136.
So he's in trouble again here. Here's the big bailout shot. That's the bailout. That's got the ship right in again for Klassen. Makes him favourite for the set again.
He certainly has some weapons.
140.
Jelle Klassen. Brilliant reply from Phil.
Is fantastic. Poor opening salvo followed by both barrels. And a great riposte. What a leg this is.
Yeah,
crucial leg.
95.
Excellent set. Double 19.
55.
Phil Taylor's already had two darts to win the set. Can he win it with this 88 finish?
Klassen may rue not going bull first out there. 18 leaves that bullseye. So this set, will it be decided by a dart at bull?
63.
Well, both men have missed darts at the middle of the board, 40. But Klassen looking for something more manageable. Double top. It's all and over. Jelle Klassen has got the first set. Phil Taylor missed three darts to take it. But the cool customer Klassen has pocketed the opening set with the darts, but that made things interesting. Very interesting.
Phil Taylor missed two darts at double 18 to win that set 3-1. Jelle Klassen eventually winning the set himself by 3-2. 2 180s in that last leg, back to back. Perfect timing. There's never been a respecter of reputations, Jelle. There is the draw. Raymond van Barneveld is into the quarterfinals after beating Michael van Gerwen. Plays Michael Smith. Adrian Lewis plays Peter Wright, who beat Chizzy in an absolute Ali Pali classic. Gary Anderson, the world champ, will take on James Wade. Alan Norris, debutant, unseeded, made it all the way through to the quarterfinal, and he would play the winner of this match. Who will it be? Who do you fancy? Jelle Klassen, a set to the good. But Phil Taylor, has to be said, Rod, has played a lot better than we've seen previously in this competition.
Absolutely, started so much better. He's started exactly the way he would have wanted to, with the exception of a couple of missed darts at double 18. Really, anyone can miss.
Second set, first leg, Phil to
but he hit double 16 and double 8 game first dart. That's been a problem area for him over recent months. Going back to the final here last year, which really hurt him against Gary Anderson. He hit a maximum, 5 140s, averaged 105.
130,
so he'll be as pleased as you can be, given that he lost the set.
140.
Well, that last set was in the balance until Jelle went max, max. Very good. And they're very good, aren't they? They're not average, are they?
Second maximum from Phil Taylor in just the sixth leg of the match. Mind you, he hit seven against Kevin Painter, in fairness, in a match that only lasted five sets. Four of them were in the last couple of sets as his game improved. Yes, pitching perfectly. Ideal.
140.
Very good leg here, leaving 44 after nine. Not much that Klassen can do about this.
60, Phil Yeung-Hwa, 44.
12? 32.
Well,
he misses twice, but on an occasion when he had plenty of time. Klassen is still not on a finish here. He is now.
81. Do we require 16?
16. Well, he's there eventually, fourth dart, and there's a bit of scowling going on from the power. It's a leg which he completely bossed by his big scoring. So he can afford to miss a few.
41.
Yeah, his scoring was phenomenal in that leg. Left 44 after just 9 darts.
84. 55.
Maybe Jelle Klassen. Maybe it's a bit warm for him. Blowing the fingers. A bit sweaty. And as you can see, Jelle Klassen, there's a fan
100.
By the side of the stage, and Jelle made a beeline for it. Maybe just feeling the heat up there. He's a fit, young, strong man.
134.
Just wants to cool his body down a sec. Let's just see if he goes back over there again to cool down. No, not that time.
140.
Phil Taylor's scoring tonight so much better, and it's not just the numbers that he's scoring, it's the where the darts are going. The first dart either on the bottom wire or just below it, which is where he wants to place it.
171.
That leaves a ton though for Klassen, and a magical 171.
Brilliant shot. Every pro loves a ton finish, 60 tops, even though Phil's applied maximum pressure. Tops. Double 10.
90. Will you require 40?
Well, he pulled the trigger twice but couldn't find the target. So tops for Taylor for a 2-0 cushion in this second set. And he's there. He breaks the Klassen throw. Well on the way now to levelling up the match at one apiece.
Well,
third leg, Phil, to throw first.
I'm not sure what Phil is eyeballing Jelle for, but only confident men want confrontation.
Easy one.
When they think they've got the beating of you. That's my experience on the dartboard. Maybe Phil fences it. Maybe there was some noise when Phil was throwing and he thought it was Jelle. We don't know.
140.
Well, absolutely evident that belief has returned to Phil Taylor's game.
60.
Swagger about him now, a confidence. An average of 107.5. And only someone qualified with sports psychology would be able to tell you if that's due to Michael van Gerwen losing, but it could only have a positive effect, couldn't it? Couldn't have a negative effect. He must have felt good about that. Van Gerwen is the man who's caused him so much problems, his nemesis over the last 12 months and more.
We'll all be pleased. Gary Anderson. Rubbing his hands to get it together. Adrian Lewis.
140.
All champions. Phil was averaging 112 in this set.
140.
He wants tops to wrap it up. Phil Taylor wins the second set. Clearly. Did he just say I'm back? Did you just say I'm back? If the belief is back, the game's back, this championship, maybe, could be Phil Taylor's after all. Do not write the great man off. 1-1. Welcome back to the World Darts Championship. Phil Taylor wins that second set. That is the stride of a man who is confident, who has regained his composure, who has regained his self-belief, who maybe just believes he can be world champion for the 17th time. We shall find out. Peter Wright beats Dave Chisnell 4-3 in another quality game. Alan Norris beats Mark Webster 4-1, took his chances well. Mark Webster missing too many doubles, 24 darts at a doubles missed, cost him dearly. One set apiece here. Yella took the first set, Phil levelled it with a set average of 112.73. We've spoken so often about Phil Taylor lacking confidence. Well, we shall say it no more. The Taylor strut is back.
In that set, he averaged 112, and his overall average is 108, Phil Taylor. Remember, Michael van Gerwen's 109 and change, the highest average of this tournament. That would be something, wouldn't it? If Michael van Gerwen were to go out and then Phil Taylor were to topple that average as well the day after.
The highest average ever in the world, 111.21. This man against Shane Burgess in 2002. If you're watching, Shane, Happy New Year to you, my man.
Oh, 60.
Well, he's throwing confidently. Klassen has got to erode that confidence by rattling in some big scores, taking out finishes, and indicating that he's in no mood to roll over. Just crank the pressure up on Phil Taylor, sow the seeds of doubt.
Well, Yella Klassen missed two darts at a double in the final leg. Well, it turned out to be the final leg of the last set. Got to take your opportunities. Averaging 101, not doing a lot wrong. Phil will be looking to leave 28. If not, a nice little 68. 108, Phil.
60.
Well, the conventional way is treble 10 or treble 18. Who knows what Yella Klassen? Well, treble 14 for double 14. Yes, how obvious.
In the first leg, Yella Klassen.
Now that is an orthodox as it gets, obviously, and it's another one that might just insert a little bit of doubt in the Phil Taylor head. Doesn't matter which way you choose to go, as long as it goes. Could have gone bull double 10, wouldn't have mattered, as long as he hits the doubles.
Oh yeah, oh yeah. Number four for Yella. He's just so capable, isn't he? Reached the quarter-final here in 2009, lost 5-1 to RVB, did Yella Klassen.
100.
Go on.
Oh. 135.
This is on the Phil Taylor throw, that's the important thing. Well, Phil Taylor, clearly put off by someone in the crowd. And because he's put off, been put off, he stopped. And because he stopped, the crowd are getting on his back and booing.
Who knows what was said and by whom?
97, who we require 161.
Displeased the power, but he's back looking at 161 here. Just too high, and Klassen will be back for 89 to go two up.
97 in the third set. 89.
Treble 19 would be my guess. Yes, clean kill and two darts. A bit like the 70 in the last leg. Oh, applause. Applause from the 16 times world champion.
To throw first. Game on.
Interesting. What do you make of that?
I just don't know what to make of Phil Taylor these days anyway. Turns up
140.
Turns up one night and plays like me. turns up the next night and plays like Phil Taylor.
Well, this Sunnyzal board of 17 and three quarter inches diameter has 20 radial segments, and Jelle Klaassen is using most of them.
45.
There's sometimes in Jelle Klaassen's play a reluctance to switch that I personally can't fathom out, because he's a very good cover shooter. Sometimes he does. Well, he's not going down for cover here.
135.
Even if he hit a single 20, he wouldn't have left to finish there, would he?
99.
Anyway. Right. 181 Klaassen after 9. Scratchy trip to the hockey here.
85.
Rectifies it.
167.
Well, he took this out in his first round match against Kita Ono. Not to be seen this time.
Well, the 96, the Dutch starting delight, Barney's match shot against MBG. Will it be the set-winning shot for Jelle Klaassen? Incredible double-double!
58. Will you require 70?
I would say there's probably one player in this 72-man field that would go double-19 with 76 on offer and two darts in hand. Phil Taylor looking at double-8.
Well, the set has become competitive again, because now Phil Taylor has the darts.
Game on.
Got to switch. They're just going in so much better, aren't they? They really are. This been spoken about so often about the mental state of 100. Phil Taylor. How the players are not frightened of him anymore, and how fragile of mind he's been. Well, you can't be that fragile of mind if you can somehow improve 100. So drastically over a few days. You've got to believe.
Brilliant again. Klaassen's had four maximums in this match already.
100.
But if he cannot break the Phil Taylor throw here, it'll come down to a really pivotal leg, which will be leg 5 in the third set. Much depending on it.
97.
If it goes that far.
Phil Taylor had darts to win the first set, lost it. Jelle has already had a dart to win this set. Number 5.
170.
He had this in the last match against Kevin Painter. He won't get it in this one at the moment, Phil Taylor, but what a setup. Leaving chops.
May go 25 route. Oh, conventional Jelle.
53. Phil, you require
40. So, tops for Phil Taylor to tie up the set and really set things twitching. Double 10 then now. Double five, and three darts have come, and three have gone. Now Jelle Klaassen, now is the time.
36, he's going the... That leaves double 18. Jelle Klaassen wins the third set. Quality finish. In that set, Jelle Klaassen took out finishes of 70, 89, and that's 68. Yes, they're not ton plus finishes, but let me tell you, if you keep taking those out, you're going to give yourself a great chance of winning.
34.
Because invariably, when you're the quality of player that's on show in this World Championship, you're going to be on them after 12 darts.
134.
Jelle Klaassen, 103.69. Phil Taylor, 106.38. Quality this year is simply incredible. It's better and better each year.
100.
Oh, magnetic darts.
177.
The confidence of the Cobra. The class of Klassen. I like the way he's going about his business, Yellow Class. He's not interested in what Phil Taylor's doing. Everything's a routine, isn't it? Back to his table, and his hands mocked up.
Nice
and moist, ready to throw again. Lovely. What a lovely leg of darts to leave 28 after 9. Superb.
Well, all these unconventional setup shots, they might be, but I'll tell you what.
140.
Is it what he's going for, Yellow Klassen? Absolutely superb. 190 and 4 darts.
Second leg, Yellow to throw first. Game on.
Well, he's averaging stratospheric stuff that he's never done before in a World Championship match.
59.
102 and a half against Joe Cullen in the first round, Yella, his best World Championship average. So you can see he's raised his game to new heights.
64.
At the moment, it's great stuff. It's given him the lead.
Phil Taylor just starting
60.
To hit a few ropey scores. Pressure telling.
Well, the point I was making a couple of sets back, Klassen had to make Phil Taylor start to doubt himself because he was swaggered off stage after set two, and Klassen had to make him think, and he has made him think, hasn't he?
Well, he's produced. He's produced at the right time.
96.
That'll work. Looking to break straight back.
Oh. Yellow Klassen had other ideas, and that 180 was the best of them. A look of confusion crept across the features of the 16 times champion. He's wondering what Klassen is still doing up there. He thinks that he could have blown Klassen out of the auditorium with what he was doing in the first two. Not a bit of it.
51 ball. This performance from Yellow Klassen, the way he's going about doing things, 190 in four darts, hitting a 180 from a seemingly lost leg. It's a bit Michael van Gerwen-like. Seems to be beaten in the leg and then just pulls out brilliance.
Two eights, Phil Taylor. Well, despite all that from Klassen, Phil Taylor keeps his composure, keeps his confidence, levels up this set. That was with a break of throw, remember? What a great game this is, the ebb and flow. Klassen throwing everything at Phil Taylor, who'd been throwing everything at the Dutchman in the first couple of sets. The crowd rising to the power.
If Phil's going to miss, he wants it there.
100.
A seventh.
The
speed coupled with the accuracy.
Only 96. If Yella can hit two trebles in this visit.
Well, the exact opposite has happened, in fact. The exact opposite has happened, to the relief of Phil Taylor, no doubt, who leads by 24 plus these. As you said, Wayne, a couple of big trebles there would have put Phil Taylor bang under it. Can he stack? Yes.
100.
Similar scenario though, two big trebles.
Indeed.
140.
He's 92. A very gettable 92. Phil Taylor going for the 19s. Now a single 19. Double 16.
76.
Well, ball or treble 20, but who knows what Yeller's got in his box of tricks. Two at double 16. One at double 16. All he needs. Yeller Klassen breaks the throw. He's throwing for a three, sets the one advantage.
Full flag Yeller to throw first. Game on.
Yeller Klassen is averaging 108 in this set. Some of his finishing.